If you have type 1 diabetes, you probably remember what it was like the first time you got an injection of insulin.
I was nervous because I thought they were going to hurt really bad.
I screamed. I yelled as loud as I could. It didn't hurt. I don't think it hurt me. I think I just was like, why are they injecting this stuff in me?
But fortunately, most people find the small needles aren't as bad as they thought.
But they ended up not really hurting, so.
What did you think of the shots that you took?
At first, the needles were a little nerve-wracking, but I got used to it pretty soon, so.
Me, personally, when I first started, I had always had a fear of needles. Mm-hmm. So that's something good that came out of with the diabetes. I'm not scared of needles anymore.
Most people use disposable syringes, insulin pens, or insulin pumps to give insulin. These devices deliver insulin through the skin and into the fatty tissue, which is also called subcutaneous tissue. Here's how to get started using disposable syringes. Before any injection, always wash your hands with soap and water and dry thoroughly. Clean the top of the insulin vial with alcohol. Pull the plunger of the syringe to the number of units of insulin you need and inject the air into the insulin vial. Draw up that amount of insulin into the barrel of the syringe. Inspect the syringe for air bubbles. It may be necessary to push insulin back into the vial and slowly pull insulin into the syringe again. Each time, observe for air bubbles in syringe. Air bubbles are not harmful if injected, but bubbles make the dose of insulin given smaller than it should be. Make sure the injection site is clean. Soap and water are preferred for cleaning since alcohol can dry the skin over time. Inject into fatty tissue. Depending on the amount of fatty tissue and the length of the needle, gently lifting the skin may help to keep the tip of the needle in the fat instead of the muscle. Wait about 5 to 10 seconds before taking the needle out of the skin. Waiting helps prevent insulin from leaking out of the skin. Dispose of the syringe in an appropriate puncture-proof sharps container. Some of our patients prefer to use insulin pens because they find them more convenient. Since the pens begin dosing at one unit, patients needing doses as small as a half unit should continue using syringes. While pens are more expensive, they are covered by most insurance, and a prescription generally covers a box of 5 pens. Most pens are pre-filled with insulin and disposable, while some pens are refilled with insulin cartridges and reusable. Some will deliver doses in half-unit increments, beginning at 1 unit. All pens give multiple injections. Here's how to get started using a pen device. After washing your hands and cleaning the top of the insulin cartridge, place a disposable needle on the tip of the pen. Turn dial to the number 2, point the needle to the ceiling, and push plunger to expel air from cartridge. You should see insulin discharge from the pen needle. This is called an air shot or priming the pen. Priming is necessary before every injection in order to place insulin in the small pen needle. Now the insulin dose can be dialed. Push pen needle into skin at a 90-degree angle. Then push plunger all the way. Slowly count to 10 before removing the needle from the skin, or you may not get your full dose. Remove the disposable pen needle and place in an appropriate puncture-proof sharps container. Some of you may be on an insulin plan that uses intermediate-acting insulin and rapid-acting insulin mixed in the same syringe. Here's how to get started mixing insulin. After washing your hands, gently tip back and forth or roll cloudy insulin vial to mix. Clean the top of the insulin vial with alcohol. Pull the plunger of the syringe to the number of units of NPH, cloudy insulin, you need. inject the air into the NPH insulin vial, and then remove the needle from the vial. Pull the plunger of the syringe to the number of units of rapid-acting, clear insulin you need, and put that amount of air into the rapid-acting clear vial. Without removing the needle from the vial, draw up the correct amount of rapid-acting, clear insulin into the syringe. Check for air bubbles and make necessary adjustments for the right amount of clear insulin, and then remove the needle from the vial. Put needle back into the NPH cloudy vial and draw up the correct amount of NPH insulin. At this point, no adjustments to the amount of insulin can be made. Never push any insulin back into the NPH vial. Discard the entire syringe of mixed insulin if you're concerned you made a mistake. Make sure the injection site is clean. Inject into fatty tissue. Depending on the amount of fatty tissue and the length of the needle, gently lifting the skin may help to keep the tip of the needle in the fat instead of the muscle. Wait about 5 to 10 seconds before taking the needle out of the skin. Waiting helps prevent insulin from leaking out of the skin. Dispose of the syringe in an appropriate puncture-proof sharps container. Now you've seen how insulin is given, so give it a try. Before you know it, you'll be giving insulin like a pro, just like the kids in this video.